The image of a mushroom cloud is one of the most recognizable sights in the world, and one of the most terrifying. Although our nuclear fears have lessened in recent decades, there was a time in the 20th century when the threat of nuclear weapons was very real, and countries were doing some truly crazy things. Superpowers around the world, primarily Russia and the United States, tested nuclear weapons underwater, in mountains, in the atmosphere, and even in space. We can probably imagine what most of those explosions would look like, but what about that final one? What would happen if a nuclear bomb went off in space? In the most dramatic stages of the Cold War, Russia and the United States were frequently testing nuclear bombs, and due to fears of a long-range missile or satellite delivery system, all eyes were on the skies. The United States launched a series of high-altitude nuclear weapons tests called Project Fishbowl. The most infamous test was called Starfish Prime. On July 9, 1962, a 1.4 megaton nuclear bomb was detonated approximately 250 miles above our planet. The resultant explosion and after effects were absolutely incredible. First of all, since there was no atmosphere in space, there was no iconic mushroom cloud, nor a blast wave, which causes most of the damage in terrestrial detonations. Instead, there was an intense outpouring of heat and light, as well as high-intensity radiation in the form of gamma rays and X-rays. Visually, the blast was roughly spherical, and the wave of radiation and light illuminated the sky. On the surface of the planet, vivid auroras of light were seen for thousands of miles, as the charged particles from the blast immediately began interacting with Earth's magnetic field. Imagine the northern lights spread across thousands of kilometers of the Pacific Ocean. Those ribbons of light lasted for hours, or even days. The debris from such a nuclear blast would burn up in Earth's upper atmosphere, and heavy ions would be absorbed by the atmospheric molecules of the planet. Even more worrying than the huge amount of radiation falling into Earth's atmosphere is the detonation's impact on electromagnetic signals. Essentially, those highly charged, rapidly moving electrons would create a small and incredibly powerful magnetic field, also called an EMP. You've probably seen this in sci-fi movies, where an EMP bomb cuts off all electronic power within a given area. In the case of Starfish Prime, that meant power outages over hundreds of miles in Hawaii, blown out streetlights, disruptions in radar and navigation systems, and a complete shutdown of electronic communication. This was an unintended consequence, but it showed scientists and researchers the true power of a nuke in space. It could effectively cripple a nation's infrastructure without physically destroying any of it. Finally, the radioactive material falling into the atmosphere dissipated and spread around the entire planet. Those extra molecules from that nuclear blast can now be accurately measured as a means of dating things, including trees, wine, animals, and even fine art. There were only a handful of high-altitude nuclear detonation tests in the 1950s and 1960s, but in total, more than 2,000 nuclear detonations were conducted on Earth between 1945 and 1998. Clearly, whether they happen on Earth or in space, nuclear detonations are never good.